Do you guys like his mustache? Okay,
a lot of work goes into it.
Oh, yeah?
Earlier, I had to just, you know, wash my hair, and I have to wash my hair here and here, and then oil this and that. It's quite tedious.
You have special shampoos for the beard, right?
Yes, we have, yes.
Okay, we're digressing.
It's Women's Day, let's forget about it.
No, we were just thinking about the kind of conditioner that goes into that. No, sorry, okay. Back we are. So, Randeep, I believe this is the first time you're going to be on a TV show as a host.
Yes, I think TV is a great medium. It has a great reach. As an actor, as a performer, I've always felt that it's a great way to reach out to people. When I was first approached for this particular show, I wasn't sure whether I'll be the correct fit for it. But when the creative head of MTV came and she explained to me the kind of stories they'll be attempted, I felt that, you know, this is something that I believe in. Something which I don't believe in. So I said yes to it, and it addresses some very pertinent questions about women today, which should be addressed and should be talked about. And also, MTV is a youthful channel, and I think I chose this because I think I connect more to the youth. My eyes and ears are more with them, and I think I'm also a teenager at heart. And as they say, dil to bachcha hai ji.
So, women and their right to desire, it seems to be the flavor of the season, actually, right, guys? So can you tell us more about the concept of the show?
Well, it is the flavor of the season, and the show deals with...
I didn't do anything. I was way over here. I'm just saying.
It's probably my fault.
Randeep, I think there's a technical glitch.
We should ask the question again.
Yeah. Coming back to the question that women and their desires and their right to desire, rather, is the flavor of the season. So, and Big F, as you said, talks about that. So can you tell us a little more in detail about it?
Well, this is a potpourri of stories from about women from different walks of life and their need to desire, need to express themselves, whether physically or otherwise. This is the second season. And I think in this season, we try to delve more into the Indian woman's psyche and address the forbidden desires. And also the fact that, you know, the social taboos should be done away with to give them confidence to do so. And it's for the men to say that, as a tagline says, orgasms don't have a gender.
We were just talking about that.
Also, that's a cool hashtag. I mean, I'm going to use that in my social. That's so true.
All right, so. Okay, so you said that the show is about letting go. You said that Big F is about giving women the right to express their fantasies, their desires. I have an awkward question. Weren't you recently accused of encouraging the mocking of a girl on Twitter for doing exactly that?
Elephant in the room.
I had to bring it up, sorry.
Everybody can see it. I think we must address it. I like to address it in three sections. First of all, the tweet itself. I didn't know who this girl was. I saw a tweet by Sehwag, and I often laugh at his funny jokes. He makes pretty funny jokes about all kinds of things. And I just laughed at it, and I left it. I didn't see the connotation in it. Then I got some messages that some prominent journalists are commenting on it and conversing on it. So I went back on Twitter, and I quickly went on the internet and saw what was going on, and I could immediately put two and two together And I very pointedly said that do not politicize this poor girl's point of view. And then those two words were taken, poor, they said you're a misogynist, and girl, they said you're a sexist. I said, hey, if it was a boy, I would have said the same thing. And I pointedly said, violence is wrong, peace must prevail, and do not politicize a young girl's point of view. And people came up with all kinds of things. Despite of being a girl, she's a thinking girl. And I said, yes, I take it for granted that if it's a girl, she will be thinking about it. At that moment, let me clarify, I was not aware of any threats to her at all. And when I did become aware of them, I immediately issued a statement clarifying my stand that it was not directed at her at all, and that violence is wrong, and violence against women is a heinous crime, and the perpetrators should be brought to justice and made an example of in a very severe way so that it doesn't happen again. I don't think that has happened. I don't know what the authorities are doing. But by that time, the narrative was set, and I was labeled, put in a box, and I was the poster boy of that acts or agendas that other people had to grind with the other people. The other people had to grind with the other people, which I found myself in the middle of. I have been labeled before, and quite similar labels which were put upon that girl. When I spoke up against Gurgaon being Gurugram, they labeled me all kinds of things, and I got a big lecture on Sanskrit and Sanskriti and all that in not such polite terms. So I shot back at them and I said, don't Sanskritize everything. Our Sanskriti is not Sanskrit. Our Sanskriti is our Sanskar. But I got the brickbats from this side. Then again, when I spoke up against Sanjay Leela Bhansali, the violence against him, I said, hinsa galat hai, ghair kanuni hai, aap baat kar sakte hai, haath nahi utha sakte. Again, another set of people, you know, trolled me. So it seems to me, I was having a conversation with those journalists as well. I was having a conversation here as well. It seems to me that we are not having a conversation anymore. We tend to get abusive. We are trolling people. And I think that is absolutely wrong. As long if you can have a point of view and you can disagree, that's fine. It's a democracy. But to put it more in perspective, I'll come to the other part, other section of my answer. Now remove me and Sehwag from it. We are men. We don't have emotions. We are not affected or hurt by the abuse we get. Put us aside. We are successful men. Doesn't matter if we work 20 years to get where we are. Put us aside. The same threats were given from this side to my mother and sister, women in Sehwag's family, Babita Fogart, Geeta Fogart. And the same threats were given when two of my colleagues, Pooja Bhatt and Richa Chadda, spoke opposing me from this side. So what is happening is that this nameless, faceless thing about trolling is going on. Whether it's a man or a woman, it's wrong to troll. And if it's a woman, it's very wrong. It's absolutely a crime. You cannot threaten a woman with violence on social media or anywhere else. And I think that is what has to be addressed, is the trolling, and especially the trolling against women. And the portal, the social media portal heads in India should look into it very seriously, because it's becoming a bigger issue and it's getting out of hand day by day. I've had brickbats from this side, I've had brickbats from that side, and I'm inviting them. Maybe I can sit with them and have a conversation about it and try and find a solution.
That's interesting, Randeep, but there's something else that you said on Twitter. You called the girl Gurmehar. You said that this girl was being used as a pawn.
It was not gender specific. As I had mentioned earlier, even if it was a boy, it would have been the same thing. It was not gender specific. It was not religion specific. And I was and I am against the politicization of any person's point of view, period. You might have an agenda or an axe to grind. Don't blow it out of proportion. You know what I mean? A similar, not a similar thing, but a thing happened. I read an article around the same time in Times of India, written by a person called Sandeep Rai, a journalist, about a girl who was gang raped, videoed, blackmailed, and finally, those guys sent the video to her father on WhatsApp and put it on social media. But there was no outrage because it served nobody's agenda. Who's going to speak up for that girl? You know what I mean? So there was an axe to grind. And considering the environment in the country vis-a-vis women today, on hindsight, I do believe that I should have been more careful. As an actor, I have faced this before, and I'm sure I'm going to face it again, as I pointed out to you. But for a young person to go through all that, I'm sure would have been very traumatic, and she should not have had to go through it.
So, Randeep, as you also said earlier, that you relate a lot to the youth of India. You are a very successful Bollywood actor. You have a great fan following.
I'm managing somehow.
The youth looks up to you, that's the point. So, do you think it was correct, or it is correct, for you to take a political stand?
That's a very big question, because like you and me, like everybody else, I am also a citizen of the country. I am also a human being. I have come from grassroots level to wherever I am today. I don't live in a vacuum. I am affected by things that happen around me all the time. I'll give you an example. I was training for my movie called Battle of Saragadi, and we were doing infantry training, and we were doing workshops, and we used to get up at 4 o'clock every morning. So one morning I woke up to the Uri attacks, and I read about it, and it was not war, it was nothing, it was a peaceful unit. These boys were sleeping in their barracks, and they were burnt alive. I was very affected by it. Then I went for the roll call, and I was doing the morning drill with the young boys. They were most of them 19, 20, 22 year olds. I looked them in the eye, and I said, and I began to care for them so much, and I looked them in the eye, and I said, what if this happened to these people, to these boys? I was very disturbed, because all talks had failed. I, in my own citizen opinion level, and there was this all talk going about how we should isolate them diplomatically and economically, and I don't know what to do next. So and there was this hashtag going around, ban Pak artists. So I wrote that if we are trying to isolate them diplomatically and economically, maybe we should also isolate them culturally. And I used the hashtag. And for that, I got different kinds of brickbats. I got silent treatment, and I still do get silent treatment from a lot of people in my own fraternity. It was my attempt, or rather naive attempt, at stopping the violence, at taking a step towards it. But it was only concluded as if it was against artists. We are artists. We are like any other person. An artist is also a citizen of a country. Now, similar to this, Meryl Streep. All of you heard Meryl Streep's beautiful speech at the Golden Globes. She was lauded. She was very witty. She was on the point. I also lauded her. And when she said that, a lot of people here said, why don't Indian actors express their opinions about all these things? This is exactly why we don't. No matter which side of the coin you are. Is it okay that if you speak against the establishment, it's freedom of speech, and you're again put into a label? And if you speak something about something you like about the establishment, you again put into a label like, you know, bootlicker and many other things I don't want to talk about. The point is, why cannot we express an opinion or a desire without being labeled? That is the problem. You can have an opinion, you might disagree with me, it's fine. And as for the youth of the country, I think we are a very young country. I think they are the future of our country, and I am not at all worried about it, because the youth today is very well informed, also because of social media, very well informed, and they are very outspoken, so there is nothing to worry about. I think they can make their own decisions.
So coming back to MTV Big F Season 2, the concept of the show is quite bold. It talks about women and their sexual fantasies and their desires. Do you think India is ready for this kind of a concept to be aired on television, mainstream television?
Well, it is 2017, guys. Why are these things still a taboo? I have a reason for it. I don't know whether you guys do or not. I have a reason for it. Because there are two Indias. It's not one India, there are two Indias. One India that has arrived, and another India that is aspirational. It is getting there. This show is about that aspirational India, where a person, man or a woman, can express his or her desire or opinion without being labeled or lynched for it. And I think, most importantly, this show talks to men. And that is why I am here as a host of the show, talking to these men, that a woman is not the object of your desire to do with her as you please. She's a person. You know, if you do it, you're a stud. If she does it, you're a slut. If she's wearing a short skirt, doesn't mean that she's asking for it. All these things have to be addressed, and it has to be addressed to the men. That is what we need to change.
But Randeep, with women in India facing so much violence, like on a daily basis, do you think a show like this is going to give, wrong ideas to men or boys?
Bus. This is exactly why we are doing this show, MTV Big F. These are the very questions we are trying to address. And it is for both men and women to understand that if a woman enjoys sex, it doesn't mean she's a slut. And if she's hanging out with the boys, it doesn't mean that she's characterless. She's a person, just like you and me, and she has the right to consent. And in fact, this is one of the main things that I am talking about in the show. And it is the idea of consent. And we've got 5 points that we've addressed through it, which are as follows. I'll read them out to you. When someone says no, it means no. It's not maybe, it's not perhaps, it's not because she's shy, it's not a game. Uski na mein haan nahi chupa hua hai. If a woman desires you, she will let you know. Trust me. And if she can't let you know because she's inebriated, that means it's an absolute no. You cannot take advantage of her. And if she's unsure, let her take her time. You cannot assume it's a yes. And if she asks you to stop midway and changes her mind, respect that and back off. She does not have to finish what she started. She doesn't owe you anything.
You're in the frame.
Ready?
Yeah.
Ready.
नहीं टीवी एक बहुत अच्छा माध्यम है लोगों तक पहुंचने का और मैं खुश हूं कि मेरा डेब्यू एक यूथफुल चैनल से हो रहा है क्योंकि उन्हीं से मेरी बातचीत ज्यादा होती है उन्हीं से मेरी बातचीत ज्यादा होती है तो आई रियली लाइक द कांसेप्ट ऑफ द शो एज वेल सिर्फ वो ऑल दोस थिंग्स दैट आई हैव नॉट ऑलरेडी आंसर्ड है आई डोंट फॉलो अवार्ड सो मच बट आई एम ग्लैड इफ इट्स गेटिंग एक्नॉलेज्ड इसके अंदर मैं बहुत काफ़ी मीटिंग्स हुई हमारी काफ़ी डिस्कशंस हुए कि क्या क्या हमें इसमें पॉइंट आउट करना चाहिए कि इंडिया सिर्फ एक नहीं है दो तरह के इंडिया हैं दोनों जगह एनवायरनमेंट अलग अलग है तो उन सारी चीज़ों को मद्देनज़र देखते हुए इसमें मेरी इन्वॉल्वमेंट काफ़ी महीनों से चल रही है फिर हमने शुरू किया
Randeep, of course, today's Women's Day, you have this show which, in a sense, empowers women. They talk about
the hidden desires, forbidden desires.
Right. But on the other hand, when you go on social media, these trolls are actually threatening them and trying to target them. Today also, we saw one such troll which was targeted at a woman who's a singer. Although she is a Muslim, she sang a Hindu devotional
trolling,
song.
Trolling is absolutely wrong. Trolling of men and women both is wrong, and trolling of women is even more wrong. You are not just not done that you threaten women, and pass lewd comments and do all those things, it's absolutely wrong. And I think today, Menaka Gandhiji, who's the minister for all this, has set up a separate cell to protect women against it. And as I said before, that the social media portals should also address it very seriously. Abusing and, you know, nameless, faceless people, abusing people and, you know, and threatening people, it's absolutely wrong. We cannot stand for it.
Also for the fact that art and artists are way above religion, creed or anything, do you think they should be targeted just for singing like this girl who just sang a Hindu song?
Absolutely. We are all humans. Recognize the whole human race as one. That's very important.
Randeep ji, aaj women's day hai to aaj social media pe dekha jaye to aaj Ram Gopal Verma ji ne tweet kiya tha women's day ke related, to aapne aapka uske us pe kya reaction
hai? Na mujhe unke tweet ना मैंने पढ़ा है और ना मुझे इंटरेस्ट है। Because it really, I really don't do much. If you look at my filmography, also things that I don't believe in, and I really believe that it is about time we started having a conversation about the forbidden things, the so-called taboos regarding women in our country. And I think it's a great opportunity. And I have really collaborated with the show creatives, and I think it's about time we started doing that, and it's about time we stopped labeling people and, you know, lynching people for their opinions and expressing their desires.
Rather than talking about women empowerment, do you think as a society it's important now to really start feeling it? Absolutely.
That's why I said there are two Indias. One India has arrived and another India is aspirational. This show is targeted at the aspirational India we all want to be a part of, where any man, woman, regardless of gender or religion, can express their opinion or their desires without being labeled or lynched. Okay? Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you.